Welcome to the last in our series on the remarkable body, and this is on the controversy on alcohol. I want to start with defining what a serving size is. And this is a 12-ounce of beer, so this is a bottle of beer, not a pint. This is a bottle, so that would be one serving. And 5 ounces of wine. This is not, if you look at a regular wine glass, and wine glasses come in all sizes, but this is a not completely full. Usually you're going to be about 3/4 of the way full, and much less full if you have it in those big fishbowl cap glasses. It's actually going to be just filling the bottom portion of that. 1.5 ounces of an 80 proof liquor, such as a vodka or a whiskey, and then 10 ounces of a wine cooler. Now, I like this picture. I thought it was pretty funny. I found it on Flickr, Creative Commons. And I wanted to point out that the beer belly is usually due to eating and drinking at the same time. It's much more common in the social drinker as compared to the alcoholic, someone who's drinking 6, 8, 10 drinks a day and not consuming food. Usually those individuals can actually be quite thin. The social drinker generally is drinking with friends, eating with friends, eating typical bar food, pub food, nachos, French fries, garlic fries, cheesy fries, you know, whatever food that there is. And alcohol is also an inhibitor. So a lot of people will not make as good decisions about food. One of my friends called alcohol the gateway drug because she thought that if she drank more that she would end up eating more food or making bad choices about food. And also, when both food and alcohol are being consumed, alcohol actually is absorbed at a slower rate. So it is a better way to drink alcohols with food. If you don't have any food, alcohol will be absorbed more quickly. But the body treats alcohol as a toxin because it is a toxin. And when it goes to the liver halts almost everything else it's doing and says, okay, I got to take this alcohol and detoxify it, get rid of this toxin. So even though alcohol does have 7 calories per gram, for every gram of alcohol, remember fat is 9 calories per gram, protein and carbohydrate are 4 calories per gram. Generally, that is detoxified and it's utilized for energy, whatever energy, because we now have this energy to burn at 7 calories per gram. And then, say, the fat that you're eating with your cheesy fries, on the other hand, is actually just going to be stored. And a typical place, especially for men, is going to be stored in the abdominal area. So that's generally what is going to contribute more to the beer belly is the consumption of the food and the alcohol at the same time. Alcohol is used for energy. The food gets stored as fat. Because if they're both contributing to energy, but you're sitting around drinking, then you're likely not burning much energy, therefore you're going to store the rest as fat. As with everything, there are positives and negatives. The positives are only associated with moderate intake, and it's only in certain groups too, and this is actually important. For women, especially women 35 and under, I mean 35 to 40 and under, no amount of alcohol is healthy. There is no amount of alcohol that is healthy because alcohol intake, even as little as one drink, has been associated with an increased risk for breast cancer. In younger age groups, in the 18, 20, both boys and girls or men and women, alcohol intake is actually only associated with an increase with risk of death, not necessarily from health problems, but from accidents, driving accidents, those types of injuries. And that we're not getting into that because it's a nutrition course. But in those age groups, there's really no health benefit. In older individuals, it can actually increase appetite, particularly in the elderly. And this is just a small amount of alcohol. The resveratrol is a phytonutrient and has been shown to have a positive effect. So we have an antioxidant and also something that has been to help decrease the risk of heart disease, along with alcohol's individual effect of inhibiting blood clotting. Now, recently there was a study that came out that showed that even that effect may not be very strong. So there may not even be a very strong correlation between even a moderate amount of alcohol consumption and decreased risk of death from cardiovascular disease. The specific group that has been targeted in the past that's been beneficial for us, typically men who are over the age of 60 or 65 and who are at risk for heart disease. And that moderate alcohol intake for a man is 1 to 2 per night, and that's it. So it's kind of in question about how much alcohol actually even has a positive benefit, but there are, you know, it's a very small subset of people. Now, the negative effects have mostly been associated with excess, and alcohol, as I said, is a toxin, and it can result in brain cell death. So all of the cells in the brain are going to be impacted by that toxin on every single exposure. It's also associated with dehydration. It inhibits the absorption of B vitamins. It's associated with hypertension and chronic inflammation. Chronic inflammation is what we think now is the underlying cause of most of our chronic diseases, everything from hypertension, heart disease, and even cancer. And excess, of course, everyone knows that if you're going to go out and binge drink and have 6 or 8 drinks, obviously, that's in excess. But usually even over 4 drinks is considered to be in excess. So it's important to kind of keep those terms in mind. And I want to emphasize what the serving size are. For men, it's 1 to 2 drinks per night, and women, only 1 drink. That is moderate alcohol intake. Now, if you average that out, we think for women, 5 to 7 drinks about per week. That does not mean 5 to 7 drinks in a night. Very important to understand that. And for men, 1 to 2 drinks, it doesn't mean 3 to 4 one night and no drinks the next night. So the slower that you drink, and if you drink with food, that means that the liver can detoxify alcohol, and therefore you don't have this circulating toxin in your body. So you have less of an impact even with those 1 drink or 1 or 2 drinks. That's also something important to consider. Well, that's going to wrap up our section on the remarkable body.